Good evening, ma'am.
Hello there, good afternoon, good evening. Good evening.
Good evening, ma'am. Can we start?
Yes, we can start now. Thank you.
Okay. Good evening, everybody. Welcome to the next session of the Mentors Program. Today we have somebody who we all been growing up. And her career from the first IPS officer in India and growing up and giving leadership lessons and motivating lakhs of people. We have the Honorable Governor, Dr. Kiran Bedi from Puducherry. Welcome, ma'am, to our session.
Thank you.
So, ma'am, without any introduction, I would first like to know how, in like 2-3 minutes, how your career went from a tennis player to a author to an IPS to the governorship.
You're starting with a question. Start away. What's your question?
The question is how has your career grown from a tennis player to an author to a writer to an IPS officer and then to a governor? How do you see your leadership journey?
Well, a leadership journey, if I look back, is full of joy and happiness. Full of sense of achievement and accomplishment. One which has been very, very worthwhile. And one which has been exceedingly demanding, very hard work. Very hard work. One which has been exceedingly supported. One which has been full of energy and good health so far. Because all this cannot be achieved without good health. I think
yes.
One has to be blessed with good health. But whether I did anything specially to maintain good health, all I can say is, yes, I took care of my health. I took care of my fitness, or the love of fitness, not to stay healthy, but played, and that kept me healthy. Not to eat to stay healthy, but I ate rightly because I believed in eating rightly, right? But health was a byproduct. And then I kept taking the opportunities which started to come my way. I didn't let them go. Every posting of mine was an opportunity to perform and do better and serve my country better. I think my life journey, if I would say, has been one with abundance of opportunities. Now, I do not know whether I created them or they came my way, but all I did was that whatever came my way, I was honest to it.
Yes.
I was authentic to it and I was self conscientious to it. I felt responsible to it and I did my duty to the utmost, not to the best. I am using the word utmost. Therefore, even if I would look at my work as an administrator in Puducherry, I would not say I'm doing my best. I would say I would do my utmost. And utmost means that that's a maximum one can do within that, within 24 hours of the day. And then my attitude is not that I did this yesterday, I don't need to repeat it today. Today I do what is the need of the day, the priorities of the day, the intensity of the day. So I think my life has been very blessed, very much blessed, very supported. It's been full of energy, full of opportunities, full of grace, full of gratitude, full of giving, full of sharing. So it's been a life of, it's been very blessed, I must say that.
So ma'am, it was by chance you got into this big administrative position, or you thought of it that you would one day become an administrator to, let's say, any of the states in India or something like that?
No, I was just one day called by our Honorable Prime Minister to say, would you like to accept this position? It came as a very remarkable surprise when I was called by the Honorable Prime Minister, and all he said was, agar aap acceptable karenge. So I said, certainly sir, what a joy it was. So it came by a design of its own kind. Now here's an opportunity. If I were wanting to be lazy, not to leave home in Delhi where I was doing a lot of work, I had a lot of speaking engagements, international universities, I was raising a lot of good funds for my foundation. I was, and my foundation was a lot dependent on me to support the projects which we had. I didn't have one, I had more than one. And hundreds of children on the side waiting to be educated. But I had to take a call, and I took my team members in confidence. And I said, now, would you be able to run the organizations yourself? It's an opportunity for you to be self-reliant. Would you? And they loved it. They said, yes, ma'am, you go, we are with you. We'll take care of the... And they did a better job than I did. They did a better job. And I'm so... You see, like, when parents get away, they probably feel children will not make it so well. But I think the moment I stepped aside, I found everybody growing so brilliantly, honestly, authentically, working so hard. And they multiplied my foundations, taken it to ISO certifications, to Give India, to most reliable, trustworthy foundations, reaching out to thousands of people in prisons, in children, in villages, in environment, in anywhere, many, many areas. They expanded and they continue to do it. So that's what I'm saying. I had an opportunity. If I were lazy, I would have said no, sir. But I thought it was an opportunity God sent. And nobody other than your own Prime Minister telling you, would you like to do it? What more? It just doesn't fall into your lap like that.
That's actually something very inspiring. Ma'am, I was listening to one of your videos when you said that COVID is a... In one of your videos, you were telling that COVID-19 is a... telling two stories of a shoe seller. COVID is an attitude.
Yes,
COVID is an attitude.
I said that. COVID is an attitude.
Yes. Can you just tell that story to everybody here, in which there were two shoe sellers, one sent to Africa and to other places?
Well, in that case, let me share with you a wonderful concept I made for you.
Yeah.
Just a moment. So, Navid, let me share with you a concept I made exactly on this, because the first of all, I want to thank you for a lovely picture you found of me in uniform.
Thank you.
I didn't have it. Navid, I didn't have it. How did you get it?
I did a lot of research.
ये मेरे पास नहीं थी फोटो इतनी पुरानी और इतनी बढ़िया मेरे पास भी नहीं थी. My daughter is thrilled with it. And so is my foundation, they loved it. And I love it too, I've saved it, by the way. So, Navid, I made a concept because you wanted me, because that's what you wrote on that leadership issues. So I have a concept to share with you. Since you are a professor and you're an academic yourself, you love it. I'll show you a concept I made. Here, show. Isha, I just made it for you. That why do I say COVID is an opportunity and an attitude?
Yes, sir.
Though it's been very, very harsh. So here is leadership in new normal. And I have got a concept of 5 A's. One of them is attitude. I'll show you the other 4. Let's go to the next slide. It's stuck?
It's fine.
Let's go to, now here is the first A, show the A, the whole A. And the next one, go to the next slide. If you have it. Watch. This is a 5A concept which I'd like to offer you at this webinar. What is it? One of the A is attitude, but I'll tell you the other four. What to me the leadership means in COVID times. Number one is accept. Why I said it's an attitude is an accept. If you got to accept it. Do you have a choice? Does anybody have a choice that I want to run away from COVID? I'm going to Netherlands, or I'm going to Switzerland, or I'm going to America. I don't think anybody would want to go. There, everybody wanted to fly out to America to join Harvard. Abhi koi Harvard Hawaii jaaz hi nahi hai, to jaoge kahan se? Number two, jaoge kya? Won't you feel probably India safer? So number one, leadership. If I, like for instance, as an administrator, what is the choice I had on COVID? First of all, is the A is acceptance. Acceptance that this is real. I can't wish it away. Jo hai, so hai. Now once you accept a reality, right? Now you go to step two. What's the second A I have planned for you? Assess. This is the time to assess who you are. When you accept it, then you say, okay, let me assess who I am. What am I? Where am I? Who am I? Where am I? What do I have? What do I do with what I have? What are my skills? Isn't it? Isn't it? I need to start assessing. Where am I? What do I do? What is the skill? And as a leader, who am I responsible for? You start assessing. You start assessing your bank account. You're assessing your personal skills. You're assessing your family needs. You're assessing the staff welfare. You start assessing. Without acceptance, assessment will not follow. Because you'll keep fighting it back. Once you say, this is real now, then now let me see what do I have. So start looking at your bank accounts. Bank account of everything. You as a healthy body. You as a... See, nobody's given us a probation for COVID. We were not on a probation. Ki abhi COVID aane wala mahine ke liye tayar ho jao. It just came. It just came. Isn't it? And it just, and the lockdown just came. If we were locked in, just came. Because at that time, life was at risk. We did not know how fast it will spread. We did not know at that time the mask will protect us. We did not know social distancing will protect us. We did not know. We did not know. We did not know Arogya Setu would come in and tell us who's close by. So it's assessment. Is assess yourself where you stand. Let's go to the third one. Then what do you assess? Is your ability. Is the ability basically I'm looking at, if I saw the SWOT. Yeah. Now, if my ability is limited and it doesn't meet the challenges, I'll go for more technology courses. Or I will upskill my management courses. I'll change my style of management. For instance, let me tell you, as an administrator, I was a very field-oriented person. 4 years, I did only field work. Every Saturday, Sunday, I was out in the field to look at different deficiencies. I've not gone out to the field because that's not the need now for me. For me, it is to keep Rajnivas safe. Because one infection in Rajnivas means Rajnivas locked down. That means your top administration's gone for a six. So I have to become very careful how do I manage the Rajnivas so that I stay in charge of the administration. Because it's like the general of the army. And if the general army of the army goes into a lockdown, who leads the army? So the next point here, therefore, is your ability. Is you upskill, you strategize, you communicate. Do you have communication ability? No, then upskill. Do you have the technical skill? No, then you upskill. So if you, all this is now talking about the third A is ability. Fourth is attitude. I told you that. The attitude is, how do you adapt? Attitude, if you remain rigid, you've had it. But your adaptability and flexibility, right? That's very important. If you were earlier not communicating enough with your staff, then you have to develop the capability. If you were not on a WhatsApp group because you were hierarchical, then you have to break the hierarchy. because you have to communicate. You are on a webinar now. You are away. You can't meet physically. How will you communicate? So ability is the adaption. The last one. And even before that, I would the first one was very important to do SWOT. Actually, it's all happening. You can do your own SWOT analysis. What were your strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats? And last one, the last A is action. It is the purpose. It is leading to your action towards your purpose you want. Purpose, which means implementation, which means follow-up, to continue to go. So these are things I thought is an attitude, but it has other four A's as well. You accept the reality, you assess yourself, you upgrade your ability, capability and ability, you get into a follow-up, and you have an adaptive attitude, willing to learn and be a student again, right? And change your habits and improve your physical, mental well-being, not only your own, but of your whole organization. So I thought to you, I would offer this as a five-way concept.
I will use it in my lectures as well, and I will use it there. Definitely.
Okay.
So, ma'am, now when we see that the leadership, internationally, when I am hosting this mentor session internationally also, we have lots of heads of states coming in. Even day after, we have the head of state of Croatia from the Balkans who is going to come. Now, how do you think that leadership has to change during this COVID-19 time? I mean, the diplomacy, international affairs, the leadership of a leader, starting from the top to the bottom, how does that has to change? What we were doing before and what we have to do now?
Well, I think the first thing would be to develop a lot of resilience. It's very, very important that you are very resilient. Because if you show yourself dithering, what has our Prime Minister shown? He's shown resilience, isn't it? I think your first thing is from fragility to resilience. And these are the ideas I picked up from a lady called Sujaya Banerjee. Sujaya Banerjee wrote a beautiful piece. I like these ideas and I'm sharing them with you. The author of these ideas is Sujaya Banerjee. And I love this factor and I rang her up. I connected with her to thank her for this very beautiful piece. And she says, from fragility to resilience. This is very, very critical. Because if you remain weak, then the whole organization will. Look at example, practical example is yesterday's Prime Minister's visit to Ladakh. What does it show? It shows tremendous resilience in the face of anything. I think that is what the leadership is expected now at the moment. Second thing which she has said is centralized to distributed authority. Earlier, we were more centralized. Now it's all distributed. What's happened in the COVID management today? Let me give you an example. Is the government of India is making standard operating procedures. Earlier, it was little centralized. But do you know what's happened? It sent out SOPs and asking the states, you design and customize. So earlier, you began with one lockdown. And as the lockdown started to recede, it started to say, now you take your own decisions. That is why Chennai is still locked down. Pondicherry is open. Kerala is open. Andhra is open. Uttar Pradesh is open. Rajasthan is open. Gujarat, but Chennai, many portions of Chennai is still locked down. And in certain parts of India, certain portions are still locked down. What happened? From centralization to distributed authority. That's what they did. Third, which I feel what she has said is bureaucratic to connectedness. The earlier bureaucracy was not so connected. It would deal with the file and it doesn't have to connect much with the people. So bureaucracy will have to communicate much more. The current leadership will have to communicate much more. Connect with the people much more. Because now the needs are changing. The equations are changing. The resources are changing. The spending priorities are changing. You cannot go in for big... Hasn't the government of India cancelled many big projects? Why? Because now it needed its resources in another form. So I think that's another way, is improving your communications. And there is also very heavy need for more transparency. People need to know. People are wanting to know how many cases of COVID are happening, where are they happening, what precautions should we do, what is the health immunity. They want guidance, but they also want information. So the more you do, the next one is to quickly adapt. In fact, I have made this concept into another few, is to be strength, S for strength, S for sharing, reshaping, which is adapting, shifting by technology, because we have to become very technology savvy. So even that's, she has used the word nimble digitally, which means those of us who are in the middle age and above, who may not be very digitally very savvy, the above middle class, but they're in the leadership position, they have to be very digitally nimble. So they have, will have to, transformational as far as learning is concerned. Then the next point is, which is eye on the growth and survival. So you have to now constantly manage survival and growth. It's not just survival, it's also growth. Somewhere it's growth, somewhere it's survival. So therefore, we have to constantly innovate. Innovation now will distinguish a leader from a follower. If the leader continues to innovate, he's a leader. Otherwise, he's a follower. So at the moment, people are expecting the leaders to constantly innovate. And that the task of the leader now is to get his people from where they are to where they have not been. They've not been there, but to take them there. That's very, very vital. This is where the people were, but take them where they've not been. But it's safe for them. It's healthy for them. It's growth for them. For instance, Atmanirbhar Bharat is to take them where they want. To manufacture pharmaceuticals more, manufacture arms, weapons more, create more medicines, PPEs earlier they were not doing, create more laboratories where they were not there, create more applications which they didn't, take them where they weren't. That is what is Atmanirbhar Bharat. That's what the leadership is. And then most of all, is commit to the employee's health. Self-health and employee's health. To me, this is safety. So survival and safety. I think this is what our leadership will need to be.
That's very true. And we have questions coming up. So ma'am, can I take 2-3 questions? I know you have another meeting at 6.
Uh-huh. Go ahead.
Okay, let me just see. The first question is with Shivani. Shivani, you have a question? No. One question we have is from Harsaina Singh. This is an unwearing test of corporate leadership. Leaders are scrambling to secure supplies and the strategic plans are falling apart. This is affecting the mental health to a great extent. How do you cope up with it?
By a decline in mental strength, the chain is not going to be revived. So first address your mental health.
That is the key. I mean, without mental health, nothing can be done.
And now the question will be how? How do you revive your mental health? There are umpteen guidance areas of reviving one's mental health. Umpteen. I'm not a yoga guru. I'm not a preacher. All I can say is I can do. Every individual has his own areas of mental nutrition. Go to those. Plug into your mental nutrition resources. Somebody is fond of music. Somebody is fond of physical exercise. Somebody is on prayer. Somebody is on yoga. Somebody is on spiritual reading. Right? Somebody is to play with children. Somebody is to be with family. I think find your own plugs of nutrition, of mental well-being. You've got to get those right.
So basically, it's your own mental resources which you have to cater.
Yes.
Shivani has asked a question. What a single key thing a female as a leader and successful person need to have in herself?
I think the spirit of self-reliance. if you have that inner feeling of I want to be relying on myself, you'll go all out to educate yourself, skill yourself, equip yourself, watch yourself, provide for yourself, but not selfishly. Self-reliance for what? Self-reliance to be self-reliant and to be a giver. Because giving brings you a lot of happiness.
So basically self-reliance is important.
Yeah.
Then we have... just a second. What do you... okay, I don't know whether you will answer this or not, but what do you think is the most important political issue at the moment?
I think if every Indian to become passionate about being self-reliant, Atmanirbhar. I think this is the issue right now. To my mind, nothing
is... And I think that's very true because, you know, every country in abroad also is very much self-reliant. I mean, they know how to get their own ways and they know how to do it. In India especially, we have that, but we need to inculcate it more and cultivate it more.
And the spirit of self-reliance. Humko Atmanirbhar banna hai. Jo bhi cheez humko... And India is capable of producing everything. We were, because we were dependent on cheaper stuff coming from outside, we became lazy and we became storekeepers instead. When we could manufacture, we became, what do they call? Big halls where they storekeeper, what do you do? They became
warehouses.
We became, you're right, we became unnecessary warehouses when we could manufacture. And they were called sometime where obviously we were surrendering to certain deficiencies and policies. And now we don't seem to be. We seem to be standing up now. Even if it's painful, even if it's slow, it's working towards self-reliance. India is a big market by itself. There'll be enough to sell even within India. And we'll save our foreign exchange substantially. That would reduce our debt ratio. So I think the major thing would be, how does every Indian start thinking, whatever my political difference be, I am going to be now working. So the farmer's child should be happy to be a farmer. A shopkeeper's son, child should be happy to be a shopkeeper. No problem. A villager needs to be happy to be and valuing the being in the village. And say, I love the fresh air of myself and I love the space. I don't want to go into Dharvi. I don't want to go into a slum tenement. So what I'm saying is, be self-reliant wherever you are. And I would love to see revival of the villages. Revival of the rural self-esteem, that I come from such and such village and I grow vegetables or I grow flowers or I create honey or I weave. So be happy even in an inherited craft of it. And today studies is online. You can do schooling online. You can pass an exam online. You can do engineering online. Today many things will happen online. You can do IT online. So therefore, I think moving towards, rather than everybody running to the city, I think it should be going back to your roots, going back to the basics for self-reliance.
We have to conclude here because ma'am has a meeting and our meeting schedule is going to get over within another 2 minutes. It is going to get expired. Ma'am, thank you so much, Honorable Governor Kiran ma'am. You have been an inspiration for every person on this planet, honestly speaking. People know you internationally and my team is very much willing to meet you, so we have met you.
She has a question. Just ask it, give him 1 moment. Yeah, go ahead,
okay.
Quickly.
Harsh, be very quick because the meeting is going to get expired, so it will just switch off on its own.
Hello.
Be very quick.
Go ahead, quickly.
Jain Varma, I am from Chandigarh. Hello.
Lovely. City most beautiful.
Ma'am, are you listening? Hello.
Chandigarh is the most beautiful India.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, 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 I am
from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from
Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from Chandigarh. Ma'am, I am from
Again, you are looking at what is wrong. You're not looking at what is right. एट द मोमेंट अपने आप पर इस वक्त फोकस करो जो सही है, इस वक्त फोकस ये मत करो जो गलत है, जो गलत है उसके खिलाफ बोलो, लेकिन इस वक्त जो सही कर सकते हो और सही देख सकते हो वो देखो। इस वक्त पॉजिटिविटी का टाइम है। क्या दूर कर सकती, मैं समझी नहीं
मैम। तो चंडीगढ़ प्रशासन के बीच में और जनता के बीच में बहुत बड़ा कम्युनिकेशन करता है, यहाँ पे कोई भी ऑफिसर जनता के लिए अच्छी तरह नहीं ले सकता है। तो हम इसमें क्या रोल प्ले कर सकती है?
ये आपका एक्सपीरियंस हो सकता है, ये जनरल एक्सपीरियंस नहीं है, लेकिन मैंने ऐसा चंडीगढ़ में सब सुना है। ये आपका एक्सपीरियंस जरूर है लेकिन जनरल नहीं है, जनरल एक्सपीरियंस में नहीं है। चंडीगढ़ तो एक वन ऑफ द मोस्ट प्रोवाइडेड फॉर यूनियन टेरिटरी, बेस्ट पुलिस यूनियन टेरिटरी, मैक्सिमम पुलिस रेशियो वहां पर है और मैक्सिमम इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इन्वेस्टमेंट चंडीगढ़ में है, उसकी मेंटेनेंस में चंडीगढ़ में है। मैं चंडीगढ़ की हूँ, मैं जानती हूँ, इसलिए मैं समझती हूँ चंडीगढ़ को इस वक्त एंजॉय करो, ये मत देखो क्या नहीं है। जाओ रोज सुखना लेक वॉक करो, जाओ वहाँ रिलैक्स करो, बाइकिंग करो, बाइकिंग साइकिलिंग करो, उसकी इतनी बढ़िया ब्यूटीफुल सड़कें हैं बाइकिंग की, रोज गार्डन में जाओ, गो एंजॉय योर चंडीगढ़। ओके, ऑलराइट, बाय बाय।